هذا هو اليوم الذي صنعه الرب فلنفرح ولنتهلل به.
المسيح قام من بين الأموات ووطئ الموت بالموت ووهب الحياة للذين في القبور.
المسيح قام من بين الأموات ووطئ الموت بالموت ووهب الحياة للذين في القبور.
Christos anesti epne kronthanaton, thanaton batisas, ketis entithnimas izoi ftharisamenos.
Well, hello everybody, welcome back to the next segment of Big Bang Thrills BTS Vlog. Yeah, it is Wednesday, well, 11 hours into the day of Wednesday, June 8th, 2016. Messiacham, Christos Anesti, and Christ is risen. As I said before, I was going to get back to you earlier, last night, and finished the vlog, but didn't get to do that, so I'm doing it here now. I'm up in the front room here. I got to do a lot of different cleaning today here, so I'll spend about 2 hours doing that cleaning. And then go back to the research desk and finish up the work I need to get done to connect not only the Academia Unity TV, but also to connect another project called OpenIP TV. I've got to connect that product to Cyborg Alpha TV Network, and I've also got to connect the iNews Network properly in a much better format to Cyborg Alpha TV. So I've got a fair bit of work to do here, and I got a fair bit of work to do back at the research desk. So let's finish up with our discussion in physiology. And where I left off was talking about the liquid part of the diet that you have to have two. Well, what I've done is I've got two in terms of ratio. I've got a 2-to-1 liquids to solids. So in other words, I have twice as much liquids in my diet as I do solids, and what that allows me to do is allows me to, I find for in terms of absorption, that's the best rate, but you also have to make sure that you have a good amount of water with this as well, so you have to sort of balance the ratio between a water and some other type of juice or tea or whatever you want to do it, or else whatever else you want. So now the choices for liquid here, and this is where you got to sort of again look into the various different types of liquids. There's two fundamental types of liquid. There's acids and then there's bases. Most of your liquids that you're taking in that are juices, coffees, teas, beer, wine, anything that's alcoholic is considered to be an organic acid. So if you're putting a lot of acids down into your system, at some point in time you're going to need to balance it out with a base. And this is your acid-base balance there. So what happens is that drinks like coffee, drinks like tea, wine, beer, act as desiccants, and they make your solid waste very rough and hard on the inside, and it scrapes along the intestines. And this is where people find a lot of pain, particularly when they're older, they have a lot of pain going to the bathroom. And because the stool, the solid waste, is now so hard and so rough, it literally scrapes along the edge. And you need something to soften and lubricate. One of the older methods of doing this is using olive oil. They would actually drink olive oil. And the olive oil in the food or in whatever they're having acts as a lubricant and softens the stool and allows it to pass through a lot easier. So, and these are sort of the things to think about. One of the things I use as a lubricant, in the terms of understanding the mechanism of the liquid that you're taking in, is basically something like a dairy, like a milk or an ice cream, like that. But make sure I've tried the two different types of milk, but whether it's fine filtered, which is basically a raw type of milk, or homogenized. I find the raw, fine filtered milk to be significantly better than the homogenized milk, the pasteurized milk, the regular milk. It does a lot better job. That does the in terms of the lactose intolerance, it just simply isn't there. I even tested it over longevity, in terms of how well it stays in the fridge, and the homogenized milk, it goes into a rot state a lot faster, significantly faster, than does the fine filtered milk. So my argument to me is there is that if that's the case there, that this the milk breaks down so quickly, then it's no use in your system. It's better to have something that's long lasting, that's more fortified, if you will, than something that is not. So this is how I balance up my acids and bases, because as you know, in addition to the lubricating factor of milk, is the fat content of milk. You also have it's a base, so you can actually take that base and reduce the amount of acidity in your body. So you can use it to counteract if your body is becoming acidic. Rather than taking an antacid, you can have a glass of milk or something along those lines that balances out the acid-base equation. So I'm going to leave this here for now, and I will see you in the next segment of Big Bang Theory, which will probably begin in a couple hours from now. But this is going to finally go up to the editing bay. The clips are filled, so we got our time, so away we go. Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to the next segment of Big Bang Theory L's BTS Vlog. Yeah, it's only about an hour and a half later since I last vlogged. But anyways, it's Messiah Khan, It's Also Nasty, and Crisis Risen. It is 12 hours and 33 minutes into the day of Wednesday, June 8th, 2016. I was thinking about it, sort of going back and forth over it. The next episode is is in the editing bay. It's being rendered. It's all edited. And so now I decide I'm going to go food shopping. So I have to get the ice packs out. The two regular ice packs are going in. Along with the two new ones. Four ice packs, I should be able to have two on the bottom, two on top of the stuff, and that will keep everything as cold as possible. So, I don't know how this is. It's about 61 degrees outside, so I'm going to wear a bit of a jacket, shorts and a jacket, that will sort of get things done. And then I'll probably see what happens is that with the backpack on, I don't always have the room to put everything I need to put if I don't have the good pockets, if I don't have enough pockets. Because sometimes the pants pockets, the things fall out of them. So I'm going to try a new method, see if it works. And then if it does work, and then yay. This is the first part. Usual backpack. Get it balanced. So let's turn this around here as we go. Alright. I'm gonna try to bring my phone with me, so I got my camera with me. But I have a camera because I'm going to try to vlog. So this is the bag. It's a camera bag that should go over here like this. And because it's in front of me like that, now I can easily get at the camera and you'll see me on the road with it. So I think that's going to be it for now. I will see you on the road as we do our peripatetics. this is the next segment of Big Bang Theory Hell's BTS vlog. I'm on the road now, going food shopping. Just wanted to try the camera out here like this, try the new system out. Seems to be working pretty well. There's a bit of a wind, and we'll see. Wow. See, here's what happened. Wind on the camera sounds a lot more, well, it's a lot louder, and in many cases, it's hard to hear. So that's what kind of, this is a test to sort of see, well, okay, we're walking in the wind. What type of, what type of sound are we getting? Not image. The image is all right because the wind doesn't affect the image. It affects the sound, but it doesn't affect the image. And so we're walking down the street here trying to get to our destination. And this is part of the problem is that when you're first leaving, your body's cold and you're not really too sure of what the temperature is going to be like. And so when I first got out of the door, I was a little cold. But now that I'm starting to walk, my body's starting to warm up. So the basically the hoodie added to the shorts, right? Instead of just walking with a t-shirt and shorts. That's sufficient. It's doing its job. So I think I'm gonna leave that short for here for now because this is the whole purpose of the clip. The clip was just simply to test us out right now. I have to get my my breath. When you first start walking out, it's a little more difficult because, like I said, your body's not warmed up yet, and that means as you talk, which takes a lot of, well, enough energy from your lungs. It takes the pulmonary energy. Sometimes it can leave you, well, yeah, it leaves you winded. I wouldn't say sometimes for me, when I'm just starting out like this, yeah, I'm winded. But as I progress and walk down the street, and the body warms up, then I'm not as winded. And of course, you have to sort of learn how to sort of catch your breath as you're talking and walking, so. It's really nice out, even when it's, a windy gray day like this, it's mostly cloudy. I really like it outside. I really enjoy the walks, the thinking that goes on. Unfortunately, we got a nice environment out here, so you know it's not all concrete. Anyways, I'm gonna leave this here for now, and I'll see you in the next segment. Welcome to the next segment of Big Bang Theory's BTS vlog. Siakam, Kasosanesti, Christ is risen. It is 12 hours and 50 minutes into the day of Wednesday, June 8th, 2016. And I know that because I got my phone with me. Yeah, the bag is working out. I tried a different configuration rather than just really have it slung over the shoulder on the side there where it keeps falling off. I decided to put it over across this way, across my neck, like this. Sort of like a side bag. It prevents it from falling off. I don't have to keep it going, worrying about and adjusting it so it doesn't fall off. And it worked. I got my phone in there, I got my keys in there, got my wallet in there. And it's a nice shell. This is one of the areas that I cut through. This is actually IBM's driveway. IBM is over there to my right. This is the sort of the parking garage. And it's a nice little area. There's actually rabbits here. There's, I've seen a couple foxes. There's some wild cats. There's a transformer station. But it's really nice. You can sort of see as you walk along here, you can see nature change. You know, during different seasons, weather conditions. It's very nice. Very enjoyable walk. I said both sides are good. Even when they have a garage there IBM seems to sort of keep their environment in a nice and clean state in some ways, in terms that it has a lot of nature to it. We have vines along the fence here. So it becomes a very enjoyable walk. And of course, if you're looking at nature itself, these are little wild grapevines. And they sort of planted these here. But the thing is, all along these areas here, they grew naturally anyways. So it was kind of, they regrew these grapes rather than planting something completely different in terms of a vine, a climbing vine. So it becomes a very nice environment, a nice enjoyable walk. And even though you are in the city, to a certain degree, we're out in the suburbs, on the edge of the city, it's not like you're walking in the city. You've got a lot of nature around you. This is a nice little bush there. Nice little flowers on the bush there. And so you've got a whole variety of different, including grass types here that are still coming through. So you can sort of take a look at the species of plants and see how the various different species intermix. So you can do, even in the city, depending on where you're filming or where you're wandering around, you can do a fair bit of research, or, you know, like if you want to study nature, you can do that here. You can see how nature stands side by side with the cement and concrete. Well, it's less cement and concrete. The concrete and steel of the city. And this is, so here's another formation here. Let's see the flowers on here. I mean, this is what's nice about the walk. And this is what I usually do about walks. I never really walk straight to wherever I'm going. I always stop, take a look at the flowers, see what plants are growing. Different things like that. And there's another set of bushes. The thing is, when these are in bloom like this, you can't, you often talk about particularly about having smell vision to smell pizza and stuff like that. Well, the thing is, you can also smell the flowers, or when it rains out, it's really distinctive when it rains out. Different water formations, depending on where the water comes from, have different smells. So if it's at lake water, that has one smell. If it's coming up from the ocean, you know, it's right, it's hitched a ride on a hurricane, and the edge of the hurricane is reaching Toronto. Then it picks up that smell as well. It smells like salt air. So, you know, different places have different smells, different rains. When it rains, different rain, depending where rain comes from, has different smell. You can even, when it's not raining out, you can tell when it's beginning to rain simply by the smell that's in the air. Because the smell of rain, the water, on the hot cement or the hot pavement produces a smell as well. And so here are more planted flowers and plants that are blooming. A very nice environment here. These are the pine trees now. So a lot to see, a lot to enjoy. Well, it's just been a few minutes. Welcome back to this next segment of the BTS vlog. This is going to be connected to it. We're walking along the major street of Steeles. And if you stop and look down below here, you look at the grass, what you can see are these nice, beautiful flowers here. These very tiny plants, very small. They have a cup shape to them. And they're all along the grass here. And this is what I was sort of saying, is that this area here was all at one point in time, this was all farmland. Actually, less than 10 years ago, this was farmland. So,
all the flowers, the species of flowers that are around when this was undeveloped are still existing today. The seeds are still in the ground and the flowers still germinate. So you have a white type of flower, right? So there's white over here. Here's white. More white. These are all white here coming up. And now you've got purple. So you have white and purple flowers here. This is what's so nice about the walk here is that you have a variety of different plant types and plant species. So you can take a, you can have a good look and see just whatever your eye can see. I mean, this is what part of observation is, looking, seeing what you can see around you. Do you walk past something as a scientist? Do you walk past something and say, I've seen that before, or do you take a look at it and say, oh, this is something interesting? Or maybe you've seen it before, take a look at it and see something new that you haven't seen before. I mean, this is, you know, science is about going beyond what you already know, testing your limits, and that means sometimes going over something you assume you know, looking in your own backyard to find something that maybe, well, here's another species of flower here. You know, finding something that you really didn't think you knew, or thought you knew, but maybe there's a different perspective and a different aspect that you didn't consider before. See you in the next segment. Well, I'm back. Jesus is the Messiah come. And Christ has risen. Everything worked perfectly. Easy to get at my keys, easy to get at my wallet, and easy to get the camera to vlog while I'm out. So I've got now a system that I can take with me so I can do the vlogging. I have a place to put the camera, a place to sort of store everything. So now that's accomplished, it's onwards and upwards to the next challenge, I guess. I'm gonna take my backpack off and get you a time and date stamp. It's still Wednesday, July 8th. But the time, I'm not too sure yet. It is 14 hours and 4 minutes into the day of Wednesday, June 8th, 2016. Yeah, so that was a good walk. It was productive. We got a lot more tested out. And, you know, that's how you learn things. You have to test things out. You have to see how it works. And sometimes things work and sometimes things don't work. In this case, everything worked out all right. So, yay for that. The second thing I'm testing out today was that the new ice packs I bought. I wanted to test those out. So I'm going to see in a few minutes how it works out, how it worked out. Whether or not things are cold enough. I made a bit of a mistake. I put things that should have been in the refrigerated bag. I left them out accidentally. That's not good. Rearrange the fridge. I can put the bag in here. Okay, let's
that works. Alrighty. The fridge is reorganized. What I had in the bag, these are the pepperoni for pizza toppings, for the pizza that I make. They had them on sale. And the bag is cold enough, it kept those relatively cool, as if they were within the freezer bag, so I'm not as concerned now. One of my favorite types of white vinegar. This is the type of white vinegar that I like to use. And now, for the test. The milk stayed cold throughout, top and bottom. There's no difference between the top and the bottom in terms of its temperature. That's good. The problem that was happening is that the bottom of the bag was staying cold because of the ice pack down there, but the top of the bag was getting warm. And more ice cream. And yay, everything fits, everything works. Our second test succeeded. The ice bags work, and yay for that. Anyways, I will see you in the next segment of Big Bang Theory L's BTS vlog. Take it easy.
Professor. And professor of what? Professor of physics.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early
light? Free speech rules here at Democratic Earth.